Nothing in this world, and we can take nothing out. The Lord gives, and the Lord takes away. Blessed be the name of the Lord. The eternal God is our refuge, and underneath are the everlasting arms. With faith in Jesus Christ, receive the body of our sister, Maxine, for burial. Our sister was washed in holy baptism and anointed with the Holy Spirit. Let us therefore with confidence pray to God, our Heavenly Father, the giver of life, that he will raise into perfection in the company of the saints. The Lord be with you. Let us pray. O God of grace and glory, remember for this day our sister Maxine. We thank you for giving her to us, a family and friends, to know and to love as a companion on our earthly pilgrimage. In your boundless compassion, console us who mourn. Give us faith to see in death the gate of eternal life, so in quiet confidence we may continue our course on earth until by your call we are reunited with those who have gone before, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Please be seated. We will now have words of remembrance by Sister Marva Best.
Good evening. As we celebrate the life of Maxine Roseanne Clark, in the garden of life was planted Maxine Roseanne Best. I could manage. Was it? Thanks. In the garden of life was planted Maxine Roseanne Best. What a rose she was. On the 13th of December 1963, she was welcomed into this world by the late Ida Best and Leon Callender of Durance Road Christ Church. Maxine was the youngest of her siblings, Marva, Wilma, Vanita, Glennis, Trevor, and Arlene. Many events mold us into who we become. And a look into Maxine's life give us an even greater appreciation and love for her. Educated at Christ Church Girls School and later at Roebuck Secondary School, being confirmed, serving as an altar server and a member of the Church Girls Brigade at the Christ Church Parish Church. The nursing of this blessed rose continued. Her employment at Barbados Steelworks, Caribbean Electronics, and various government agencies would further enhance her experiences of life. One of her most precious accomplishments was that of her beautiful family. Maxine met the love of her life, William, and married on the 22nd of August 1992, and resided in Royces, St. Philip, and later Caveland, St. Philip. She was embraced by his family as they all attended the People's Pentecostal Church together. During Maxine and William union of 30 years, they had two beloved children, Katrina and Andre. This love showered down to her granddaughters, Kashana and Kashana. Maxine was proud of their achievement. Maxine had many wonderful qualities that will forever be etched in our hearts. She enjoyed life. Her love of a good laugh and dancing radiated to those around her. She was the life of the party. Maxine was a magnificent cook and baker. She was the family seamstress. All you had to call and say, "Mom, sis, auntie, I need something made or altered." She was a cricket fan and a member of the Sunrise Community Club. Love never withers in our hearts, and Maxine was love and is love. On behalf of Maxine's husband, children, grandchildren, siblings, and all other family members, we extend thanks to all of you who are here to celebrate the life of Maxine. We also thank those who sent cards, messages, and shared encouraging words. May Maxine Roseanne Clark rest in peace and rise in glory.
Thank you. We now have a musical tribute by Charmaine Braffett.
Good evening.
The title of the song I'm going to sing is Jesus Stay at the Wheel.
She was driving last Friday on a rain in Cincinnati on a snow white Christmas Eve. Going home to see her mama and her daddy with the baby in the backseat. 50 miles to go, she was running low on faith and gasoline. It's been a long, hard year. She had a lot on her mind and she didn't pay attention. She was going way too fast. Before she knew it, she was spinning on the same black shitty glass. She saw both their lives flash before her eyes. She didn't even have time to cry. She was so scared. She threw her hands up in the air. Jesus, take the wheel, take it from my hands, 'cause I can't do this on my own. I'm letting go, give me one more chance, save me from this road I'm on. Jesus, take the wheel. He was still getting colder when she made it to his shoulder and the car came to a stop. She cried when she saw that baby in the backseat sleeping like a rock. And for the first time in a long time, she held her head to pray. She said, I'm sorry for the way I've been living my life. I know I got to change. So from now on tonight, Jesus, take the wheel, take it from my hands, 'cause I can't do this on my own. I'm letting go. So give me save me from this road I'm on. Oh, Jesus, save the wheel. Oh, I'm letting go. Give me one more chance. Save me from this road. Take the wheel. Oh, take it from me.
Oh, rest in peace, Maxine.
We now stand and sing the hymn 387, To God Be the Glory.
Thank you.
us bow our heads in prayer. Almighty God, we remember for today your servant Maxine. I pray that having opened to her the gates of larger life, you receive her more and more into your joyful service. With all who have served in the past, she may share an eternal victory of Jesus Christ, our Lord, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever. Amen. Please be seated for the first Bible reading by Laura Kinch.
Good afternoon. A reading from the Word of God written in 1 Thessalonians chapter 4, verses 13 to 18. But we do not want you to be uninformed, brothers and sisters, about those who have died, so that you may not grieve as others do who have no hope. For since we believe that Jesus died and rose again, even so, through Jesus, God will bring with him those who have died. For this we declare to you by the word of the Lord, that we who are alive, who are left until the coming of the Lord, will by no means precede those who have died. For the Lord himself, with a cry of command, with the archangel's calls, and with the sound of God's trumpet, will descend from heaven, and the dead in Christ will rise first. Then we who are alive, who are left, will be caught up in the clouds together with them to meet the Lord in the air. And so we will be with the Lord forever. Therefore, encourage one another with these words, the word of the Lord.
Thanks. Remain seated. The choir will stand as we will sing together the Crimon version of Psalm 23, the 23rd Psalm, the Crimon version.
Thank you.
Before we have the second lesson, could please the driver of P7361, P7361, could you please move your vehicle? Someone wants to get out quickly. We now have the second lesson, read by Verona Seal.
A reading from the Word of God, written in the Gospel according to St. John, chapter 14, verses 1 to 6. Do not let your hearts be troubled. Believe in God. Believe also in me. In my Father's house there are many dwelling places. If it were not so, would I have told you that I go to prepare a place for you? And if I go and prepare a place for you, I will come again and will take you to myself, that so that where I am, there you may be also. And you know the way to the place where I am going. Thomas said to him, Lord, we do not know where you are going. How can we know the way? Jesus said to him, I am the way and the truth and the life. No one comes to the Father except through me. The word of the Lord.
The hymn now, 497, Blessed Assurance, Jesus is mine. I speak in the name of God, who is Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. Amen. Please be seated. Let us first of all offer condolences to the family of Maxine Clark and to assure you that we will continue to remember you in our prayers as we pray not only for you, but we pray with you. Our departed sister was involved in the ministry of this church for many years until she got married and moved to St. Philip. And therefore, I offer condolences on behalf of the parish, not only to her husband, to William, but also to her children and grandchildren and other sorrow relatives. We pray also with you from the point of view that there are members of your family who are still involved with the ministry and mission of our church. We offer specifically to her sister, Marva, and as I said, other members of the family. Now, I've seen already in preparation for this funeral service and just prior to the start of this particular service, the sense of loss, the profound grief at the loss of Maxine. And I want us, therefore, to think about the reality of grief and to do it in the context of the scripture from John chapter 11. And in John chapter 11, we have a situation where Jesus experiences grief. And for those of us, of course, who have been involved in a ministry of a church, Sunday school, like our departed sister, others generally known, we would know that, at least in the King James Version, the shortest verse in the Bible is, Jesus wept. Jesus wept. So if Jesus is involved in weeping, Jesus wept. Therefore, we have to take into consideration, what does grief mean? What does grief mean? Now, let's first of all establish that we are Christians, if we are Christians, if we're called to be Christians, and we're not Stoics. Stoics was a philosophy which was around the same time, of the first century, especially in the ancient Near East. And the Stoic philosophy was this, that really things will always happen, there will always be death, there will always be misfortune, so therefore what should you do? You shouldn't collapse, you shouldn't break down, you should be stoic about it. You should just accept and therefore show no emotion. Not so as part of the Christian faith. If Jesus is the way, the truth, and the life, it means therefore that our emotions matter. And therefore when we cry or when we weep, it is not something that should be foreign or something that we should run away from, but seek to understand. And of course, when we weep, when we are in mourning, it's from the reality that we mourn someone or something that was dear. I don't think that many persons will really think about something that is of no use. So sometimes even when that is gone, we say good riddance. But not so, of course, when we've had someone in our life or something of importance. Sometimes it could be something material, which will give us a sense of a connection to a particular time or a particular person. Or indeed, it could be the person itself. And therefore, when we lose them, it will cause pain. So therefore, to grieve in terms of to cry, to weep, is not a foreign thing or shouldn't be a foreign thing to our experience. And it shouldn't be a foreign thing to our experience because even in the reality of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ was basically one of the texts or the verse from the text for last Sunday's gospel reading. Jesus said, blessed are those who mourn, for they shall be comforted. Blessed are those who mourn, for they shall be comforted. So therefore, it's not something that we should say or turn our backs upon, but we should seek to understand it. But as with most things, of course, mourning, because we, of course, are different, we have our own personalities and circumstances, we're not all going to react or indeed respond in a particular way. Some people will show their mourning through a tear. Some persons will show their mourning in other ways. And therefore, we need to be genuine. We cannot at least we should not seek to force it. It must be genuine. And it must be genuine from the point of view, sometimes it can happen right at the moment and we realize that someone has passed, or sometimes it can be weeks afterwards. And sometimes we've said not to deal, we haven't dealt with it properly, and that it can come out in maybe unfortunate ways, but it must be genuine. I recall an occasion where a lady was very honest about her relationship with her husband. Apparently it was not a good relationship. And therefore, when he passed, she said, "Well, it's going to look so bad if I'm not crying." And therefore, when persons came around, she decided to rub her eyes and make them red. That is not genuine. That is not the way that should be involved. So therefore, accept the reality of persons will be taken away from us. We will lose persons. But let our grief, let our mourning be genuine. Jesus wept because he had a relationship with Lazarus, his friend. And therefore, we have to embrace it in the same way. The other aspect we have to also note is this, that it is an opportunity when persons are grieving to try and be there for them. One of the real difficulties, of course, as we would know, an experience for some families, that they had to deal with the reality of the death of a loved one, but because, of course, of COVID and other restrictions, we even had to register to go to a funeral service. We had situations where family members could not be present. Someone was very dear to them, especially if it was a large family, we were down to 20. So on this occasion, for those of us who are here, it is good, I believe, for you to show your love in a tangible way, to be there, and therefore that they can understand that blessed are those who mourn, for they shall be comforted, because they will know that they don't have to face this by themselves, that you are here with them to support them by your physical presence. Because, of course, there are a number of things, a contradiction or things that didn't make sense for us, so we tried to come to terms with during the COVID period. But I believe the one that didn't really make sense when you thought about it is the term social distancing. Because, of course, it's a contradiction in terms. We are social animals. And therefore, as a social person, as it says in the God's word, it's not good that man and a woman be alone. And therefore, that's why we are involved in relationships. And therefore, to show today that we are there and here for this family by our physical presence. But once again, it has to be genuine. Again, a gentleman, friend of mine, said, well, he likes to go to these funerals, but he doesn't like to stay. And what he does signs a book, and he's gone. Now he says, well, he could see that I was there. I attended, but he wasn't really there. He just passed through. And sometimes, of course, persons want to be seen. Well, I was at the funeral. But were you really there? Were you really there? And I hope and pray. I really hope and pray for this family that we can be physically there to support them, not only by our presence, but what I want us to really talk about today is to be there with us, with them, and for each other, for you yourselves, through our prayers. Our presence and our prayers. Presence and prayers. This family selected, as part of this funeral service, a very familiar hymn. It's the last hymn. We can sing it after the prayers. And it states, "What a friend we have in Jesus, all our sins and griefs to bear. What a privilege to carry everything to God in prayer. Oh, what peace we often forfeit. Oh, what needless pain we bear. All because we do not carry everything to God in prayer." Beautiful hymn. Moving hymn. sound theology. Now, sometimes persons will tell you about a particular song that God loves us from a distance. God loves us as a distance. It's a nice song. And Bette Midler sings a song. But it's not really good theology. Because you see, with God, He's not just at a distance. He's not at a distance. In fact, we affirm this at Christmas. And sometimes you kind of think, well, after the 12 days of Christmas, that's it, it's over. But it says, Emmanuel, God is with us. And He's not just with us during the good times. He's with us in all times. And what He was trying to help though His disciples to know, not only as He shared in the loss of a family, of someone who was a friend of Lazarus, but He committed His disciples just before He would be taken away at one level physically. He said to them, I want you to the Garden of Gethsemane to pray. To pray. And to understand that what I'm going to do for you, also for your loved ones, will have an impact that even though sometimes it may seem and it may appear that I'm away from you, remember, I'm saying, lo, I am with you always, even to the end of the age. And therefore, you can, family, and we together can know that we can be physically present as best as we can. But sometimes, of course, there comes a time when we have to get on with our own life. We also know that sometimes we can have a wedding service, but it says what? Till death do us part. But there's something that we heard as we entered the church today. And this is saying this of Paul. I am sure, I'm convinced that neither death, nor life, nor angels, nor principalities, nor things present, nor things to come, nor height, nor depth, nor anything else in all of creation will be able to separate us from the love of God in Christ Jesus our Lord. And therefore, what I encourage you to do is this, to offer your dearly departed sister, your wife, your family, your mother, your grandmother, your work colleague, your neighbor, lift and offer her to Almighty God in terms of Maxine, and know that you're offering to the one who has loved her the most. But don't leave it there. Offer your own self to the same God, the same one who weeps not only for us but with us, so that we will know and understand that these words are so very true. How be trials and temptations, is there trouble anywhere? We should never be discouraged. Take it to the Lord in prayer. Can we find a friend so faithful who will all our sorrows share? Jesus knows our every weakness. Take it to the Lord in prayer. May she rest in peace and rise in glory. Amen. Now stand. And if it is our faith to say the words of the Apostles' Creed, the Creed of our baptism, I believe in God, the Father Almighty. Please be seated as we bow our heads in prayer. We pray for those who mourn for Maxine We commemorate the departed. Let's pray with confidence to God, our Father, who raised our Lord Jesus from the dead for the salvation of all. And grant, Lord, your servant, Maxine, may know the fullness of life which you have promised to those who love you. Lord, in your mercy, be close to those who mourn. Increase their faith in your undying love. Lord, in your mercy, may we be strengthened in our faith. Live the rest of our lives in fellowship with your Son and be ready when you call us to the fullness of life. Lord, in your mercy, show your mercy to dying, strengthen them with hope, and fill them with the peace and joy of your presence. Lord, in your mercy, we commend all people to your unfailing love, and then your will may be fulfilled. And we rejoice at the faithful witness of your saints in every age. Pray we may share with them in your eternal kingdom. Lord, in your mercy. Father of all, we pray to you for Maxine, for all those whom we love but see no longer. Grant to them eternal rest, that light perpetual shine upon them. And may she and all the faithful departed to the mercy of God rest in peace. Amen. The hymn, What a Friend We Have in Jesus. Christ is risen from the dead, trampling down death by death and giving life to those who seek him. The Son of Righteousness is gloriously risen, giving light to those who sat in darkness and the shadow of death. The Lord will guide our feet in the way of peace, having taken away the sin of the world. Christ will open the kingdom to heaven to all who believe in his name, saying, come, O blessed of my Father, inherit the kingdom prepared for you. Into paradise may the angels lead you. At your coming may the martyrs receive you and bring you to the holy city, Jerusalem. brother, our sister, Maxine, Roseanne, and we commit her body to the ground, earth to earth, ash to ashes, dust to dust. And we beseech you in your infinite goodness to give us grace to live in your dear love and to die in your favor, that when your well-beloved son should come again in judgment, both this old sister Maxine and we ourselves be found except for your sight, rather for the sake of your son, Jesus Christ, our Lord. Grant, O Lord, to all our bereaved the spirit of faith and courage, that may have strengthened me the days to come with steadfastness and patience, not sorrowing as those without hope, but in thankful remembrance of your great goodness and in the joyful expectation of eternal life with those they love. And this we ask in the name of Jesus Christ, our Lord. Rest eternal grant to her, O Lord. May she know the faithful departed, the mercy of God, rest in peace. The Lord bless her and keep her. The Lord make his face to shine upon her and be gracious to her. The Lord lift his countenance upon her and give her peace. Amen.
The hymns, how great is our God, when the roll is called up yonder, I'll fly away in the sweet by and by.
The splendor of clothed in majesty, let all the earth rejoice, all the earth rejoice. He wraps himself in light, and darkness tries to hide. It trembles at his voice, trembles at his voice. How great is our God? Sing with me, how great is our God? And all will see, how great is our God? And age to age, and time
is our God. faith we can see it afar, for the Father waits over the way to prepare us a dwelling place there.
To him who's able to keep us from falling and present us faultless before the presence of his glory with exceeding joy, to the only wise God, our Savior, be glory and majesty, dominion and power, both now and forever. Amen.
Thank you. For your mercy never fails me. All my days I've been held in your hand. From the moment that I wake up until I lay my head, oh, I will sing of the goodness of God. All my life you have been faithful, and all my life you have been so, so good. With every breath that I am able, oh, I will sing of the goodness of God. I love your voice. You have led me through the fire, and in darkest night, you are close like no other. I've known you as a father, I've known you as a friend, and I have lived in the goodness of God. 'Cause all